It was 100 years ago today, November 26, 1910, a Saturday, that Newark experienced the worst fatal fire in its history at a four-story Civil War-era brick factory building on the corner of High and Orange Streets in this lot behind me to the left. That day started off uneventfully enough for the 100 or so women who were busy on the building's top floor making nightgowns in preparation for the Christmas rush, getting paid mere pennies an hour for their labors. But all that changed in a heartbeat just after 9:30 a.m. when a fire started in a lamp company on the floor below, the flames racing up through the building and quickly destroying everything in its path. With no time to prepare or spare, the women scrambled for a way to safety, only to be blocked from the lower floors by a locked door, and then confronted with fire escapes, drop ladders really, that were neither readily accessible nor suitable for a mass exit. In their rush, they panicked, and who could blame them? But it made a horrible situation that much worse. Within 10 minutes, 26 girls and women were dead, some from being burned to death when they couldn't find an exit or get to one fast enough, and others from jumping to the pavement. 40 more were injured, some for life. No fire in Newark's almost 350-year history has taken a greater toll on human life. A variety of probes into the fire found that, while no person, public official, or corporate entity could be held responsible for the deaths of the girls and women, it did find that the ordinances in the city and the laws of the state were not strong enough to have protected them. Investigators also determined that there were many other industrial buildings in Newark with conditions as bad or worse than the one on High Street. So change came, and it came fast. Within a year, standard rules for the installation of fire escapes, along with fireproof windows, fireproof doors, and other fireproof equipment, were approved across the state. Standard rules for the installation of factory fire alarms were also approved, along with requirements that all elevators be fireproof, that fire drills be held at factories every month, and that all industrial buildings be approved for occupancy by the State Labor Department prior to opening. Officials in other jurisdictions, shocked by the experience on High Street, began following suit. Once the fire at the Triangle Shirtwaist Company struck in Lower Manhattan 4 months later, March of 1911, killing close to 150, public safety officials everywhere realized the sweeping potential for disaster that factories were posing to workers in their own communities, and they too began addressing these issues. It is by no means a stretch to say, in terms of improving workplace safety, that the fire in Newark started what Triangle ended. And so it is we remember the 26 who died here 100 years ago this morning, and say for the world to hear that they did not die in vain. For theirs is a legacy that will live on as long as there are employees and workers, as long as there are buildings that people work in, and as long as there are individuals who remain committed to making certain that workplaces are as safe as possible for the health and well-being of everyone. Thank you, and please welcome Newark Central Ward Councilman Darren Sharif.